Hi, welcome to Kalipso Tutorials. In this first tutorial, we would like to take you on a tour to get you comfortable with the environment. We'll provide you the knowledge to be able to create and test your first project. Let's call it Tutorial 1. Open your Kalipso Designer and press Create a new project. First thing to do is provide the name of your project. Let's call it Tutorial 1. Also, here is where we can choose from a list of themes to use in our application. All themes bundled in Kalipso already have some generic style forms and some variety of controls to use as a starting point. Here we select this one. These parameters are meaningless to Kalipso, but they can be very helpful to you. You should use them to identify the version of your project and database, and we have access to them in runtime. Use them to make version logs or even to check if the current version is up to date. Although you can deploy your Kalipso project into any device running Windows CE, Windows Mobile, Windows Desktop or Android, we must associate a specific device with our project. The purpose of this property is to define two things. First, the base resolution of our application, so when designing your forms, they will have the dimension of the screen defined. Still, you can deploy your project into devices with different resolutions and ask Kalipso to adjust itself to the new size, even if smaller than the one we are defining as being the base one. Second, in order to use the keyboard to trigger actions in our project, the keys must be defined at device level, providing to Kalipso the ASCII code of each key we want to capture. For your convenience, most of the devices listed here already have the keyboard defined. If not, you can press this button to do it so. Let's switch to the Keys tab and, for example, we can see that the Enter key is defined as ASCII 13. Although we don't need to specify any more parameters, let's take a quick review on some of the most important ones. If you want to customize your application's icon, press the K logo and then choose Define option. A file picker comes up and we should choose an ICO file of 32x32. When done, just press Open. Since I'm leaving the default icon, I'm going to cancel. Let's move to the Others tab so we can check a couple of optional parameters. Like I've said before, we can set our project to automatically adjust to the device resolution. You can choose from Default, where Kalipso will adjust if it's an Android device, but not if it's a Windows. This option is useful if you need to deploy to Windows Mobile, Android and Desktop. 90% of Windows Mobile devices are 240x320, so no problem there. On Android, it adjusts, so no problem there. In Windows Desktop, you don't want your 240x320 forms to resize to a 124x768 resolution or higher. Then we have the device-dependent pixels, where Kalipso will adjust if it's an Android device and will ask the operating system to adjust to the new size if necessary. No resize to always run in the same resolution and automatic resize, where Kalipso will adjust the application size to the device resolution regardless of the operating system. So, all we have to do now is to press the Save button and define where we want to save our project. A best and recommended practice is to create a unique folder per project, since Kalipso will store all the files related to your project in it. I'm going to call it Tutorial 1, open it, and it's also useful to know that you can backup the entire folder with the guarantee that everything you need is there. I'm going to press Save and wait for Kalipso to create and open our project. Here it is. At left, we can see a tree with our project objects, and here we can see the objects we can create. Let's press the Form button to create our first form. Notice that since this is our first form, Kalipso automatically sets it has the first form. Let's give it a name and a title. I'm going to call it main with the title main. By default, Kalipso creates maximized forms. If you want, you can create either full screen forms or independently control the visibility of title and the system bars, or specify the exact dimensions of it. I'm going to create a maximized one with the system bar enabled. When done, press save. In the same bar where you created the form, you can now see a list of objects that you can add to your form. Since this form already has some controls, you can use and customize them. You can move a control by dragging it or using the arrow keys on your keyboard. You can also resize them by using the handles or using the shift key along with the cursors. We now want to close the form when the user clicks on this control. To do it so, we go to its properties by double-clicking it or pressing F3 or the control icon in the toolbar. Here, we switch to the Actions tab. We can now see all the events that can be triggered and captured for a button control. At left, there's a list of actions from where we can choose what to execute. These actions are divided into groups and subgroups. The one we're looking for is Close Form, so it should be under the Forms group. All we have to do now is drag and drop it into the click event. We can see a properties window popping up. Since we don't need to input any action parameters, we just click save or press enter. An alternative to this method would be just typing the word close. As you can see, Kalipso automatically places the cursor in this combo box and lists all the actions starting with close and then the ones who have close in their name. We can just select the one we want, the same properties window opens up, we press save and the new action is created right after the one that was selected. This alternative method is useful to search for actions, as their name tries to be as intuitive as possible. Since we've added an extra close form, let's remove it by right-clicking and choose delete, or as the shortcut indicates, by pressing the delete key. Finally, we press save button or enter. It's now time to test the application. Since Kalipso has a built-in simulator, there's no need to use an external device. To test the project, we can either press F10 key or the test button in the toolbar. In the window that comes up, we press the test button. Kalipso is now automatically saving the project and deploying it to the simulator. Here's your first Kalipso application running. If we press the exit button, the application should close and we are back to the designer. Although your application can be tested on a simulator, you're also able to test it in a USB attached device. If it's a Windows Mobile or CE device, you need to install Windows Mobile Device Center. In case of an Android, you need to enable the developer mode and USB debugging. In case of Windows 10 devices, you must install the Windows SDK. Having that steps completed, click the arrow below the test on the device and select on PDA button in the toolbar. Choose between Windows or Android. If the icon already displays the target platform, you can press Ctrl F10. I'm going to start by deploying to a Windows Mobile device. In the window that comes up, we can define the folder where Kalipso framework should be installed. I leave it as it is and just press the next button. We can see the display of my device here. And here comes the application. Now, to do it in Android, you'll repeat the process. Finally, repeat the process for a Windows 10 device. Finally, repeat the process for a Windows 10 device. Congratulations! You've concluded the tutorial on how to create your first Kalipso application.